Welcome to this video on editing and deleting columns in SharePoint 2013. The methods demonstrated here are the same for both lists and libraries, so we'll use a list as our example. This video also explains how to set default values for columns using library settings rather than column settings. Once you've created a column, you may need to change its settings occasionally. Let's go to a list of ferries to see how to do this. First, we'll change the name of a column. Click the List tab in List Settings. Scroll to the Columns area and click the Name column. Add Ferry to the name, then click OK to save the name change. Let's return to the list to see the column we just renamed. Now, let's modify the Training Status column to include another option in the choices and to make the information required. Click the List tab in List Settings. Scroll down to and click Training Status. Here's how to make the information required. And we'll add an option of Not Scheduled to the choices. Click OK to save changes and return to the list. The Hatteras Ferry has complete information, but the Ocracoke Ferry is missing crew and manufacturer information. Let's begin to complete the information for the Ocracoke Ferry. Edit the item and select Wilder as the primary pilot. Click Save. As you can see, the requirement to enter training status applies to all list items, not just ones added after the column was changed. Let's make the training status not scheduled and save the item. Another editing option is to change the order of the columns in the dialogs. For example, in the New Item dialog, we want to swap the order of fare and route. Go back to the list, then click the List tab in List Settings. In the Columns section, click Column Ordering. Use the drop-downs to reorder the columns. For Route to precede Fare, we'll need to change the position of Route from 4 to 3. Other columns are automatically renumbered. Click OK, then return to the list. This reordering option affects dialogs, not views. So you see no difference in the views, but if you click New Item, you'll see that Route has moved above Ferry. To change the order of columns in a view, you'll need to edit the view. To delete a column from a list, go to the List tab and List Settings. Scroll to the Columns area and click the column to delete. Here, we'll select Knots. Scroll to the bottom of the page, click Delete, and click OK to confirm the warning message. I don't actually want to delete the Knots column, so I'm going to cancel out of the message, then cancel out of the Edit page. Be very careful when you delete a column because it cannot be restored from the recycle bin. When you create or edit a column, you can usually set a default value. In a library, you can also set the default value of a column. Let's look at a documents library. The Filter By column records the release year for each document. It would be convenient to have the default set at the current year. Click the Library tab and Library Settings. Click Column Default Value Settings. You'll see a list of columns, default values, and other properties. Click Filter By to change its default. Click Use This Default Value, enter 2015, and click OK. And 2015 now appears here. Navigate back to the library. If you drag a Word document from your desktop to upload it into the library, the default value of 2015 is automatically assigned in the Filter By column. In this video, we've reviewed ways to edit and delete columns and to assign default values using library settings. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. go to the main Help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the Help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC Training Group. Thanks for watching.